This tutorial shows how to create an exclusion dictionary in Microsoft Word. Hello, my name is Erin. I'm a technical writer and editor who shares step-by-step software tutorials and writing tips for the real world on this channel and on my blog at erinwrightwriting.com. Today we're going to look at how to create an exclusion dictionary in Microsoft Word. An exclusion dictionary is a list of words that will always be marked as incorrect by Words Editor, which is the spelling and grammar check, even if they're spelled correctly. You may want to add frequently confused or inappropriate words to your exclusion dictionary. Before we begin, please allow me to quickly share a few important notes. Most importantly, the particular steps shown here are for Word from Microsoft 365, Word 2019, Word 2016, and Word 2013 running on Windows 10. These steps won't work on older versions of Windows or on a Mac. In addition, the words you add to your exclusion dictionary apply to all your Microsoft Office apps, such as Excel, PowerPoint, and Outlook, not just Word. Lastly, we're going to locate the exclusion dictionary file through the File Explorer. The location of my file will also be the location for most other Windows users. However, there is a chance that your file will be located elsewhere. We'll move through several layers of folders within the File Explorer. Please note that I've created a companion blog post showing all the steps with images so you don't have to worry about writing down the order of the different folders. The blog post is linked in the description box below. To begin creating your exclusion dictionary, press the Windows key plus E on your keyboard to open the File Explorer. Alternatively, you can search for and then select File Explorer in the search box in the taskbar. Next, select the Windows C drive in the File Explorer. Once in Windows C, select the Users folder. And then select your username folder. For example, my username is Erin. Now select the View tab. And select Hidden Items if it's not already selected. This will allow you to see folders that are normally hidden. You should now be able to see and select the App Data folder. Once in the App Data folder, select the Roaming folder, followed by the Microsoft folder. Finally, select the Uproof folder. Within the Uproof folder, look for a file that says Exclude Dictionary, followed by a letter and number code matching your language and geographic region. Each language region combination has its own exclusion dictionary file. So you may see more than one exclusion file in your Uproof folder if you've used more than one language while working in Word or your other Office apps. The exclusion dictionary file for English in the United States is Exclude Dictionary EN0409. Here are several other English language examples. You can find the complete list of codes in the documentation section of the Microsoft website, which I've linked in the description box below. Once you've located the correct file, right-click it and select Open With from the shortcut menu. Next, select Notepad from the How Do You Want to Open This File dialog box. You may have to select the More Apps link to locate Notepad. You can also choose WordPad if you'd like. Once you've made your selection, select the OK button. Now, type the words you want to exclude, which are the words you want Word to mark as incorrect, on separate lines in Notepad. When you're finished, select the File tab, followed by Save from the drop-down menu. And then select the X to close Notepad, and the X to close the File Explorer. If Word is open, save your file, close Word, and then reopen it. Your exclusion dictionary changes should take effect after you reopen Word. I have created many other videos about Microsoft Word, including how to create a custom dictionary in Microsoft Word and how to create a citation with multiple sources in Microsoft Word. Please see the complete list in the playlist titled How to Use Microsoft Word, which is linked in the description box below. The companion blog post for this video showing all the steps we just performed appears on erin.writewriting.com, which is also linked below. Feel free to leave me a comment if there's a specific topic related to Microsoft Word, Adobe Acrobat, or Google Docs that you'd like me to talk about in the future. And please subscribe to my channel so you don't miss future tutorials, and give this video a thumbs up if you found it helpful. Thank you so much for watching.